My name is Rick Perkins, and I played on the Ramsey High School basketball teams in 1962 and 1963 with Dave Oviatt, who was the leading scorer and a really fine player on those teams. And in 1964, I was the captain of the Ramsey High School team, playing with Dick Oviatt, another really fine player. Dave and Dick and I started practicing basketball at the courts at the elementary school on School Street, I think in the sixth grade. We were really dedicated to basketball players. We got a little bit older and we graduated to the courts at Finch Park, where we played all summer long. Later in 1963, Dick and I went to the basketball camp of the legendary college coach Claire B, where we played 4 weeks of basketball with some of the top players in the East Coast, high school players that is, and we played day and night and really improved our skills. And it's a wonderful experience that Dick and I had there, and we really got better. So that for the 1964 season, our coach, Gordon Bedford, was very pleased. We won our first 8 games. I remember Dick calling us the Jolly Green Giants. We had 3 guys who were 6'5", Dick Oviatt, number 50, Bob Burdekin, number 13, and Jim Romaines, number 40. So a 6'3" guard like myself, I had to play outside because we had such strength and power inside. We went on to have a very good season. You know, our coach was Gordon Bedford, a very successful coach and then athletic director at Ramsey. That 1964 team went on to win the league championship and won 2 games in the state tournament. And one of the things that made it successful was that Dick, at 6'5", had developed this great fadeaway jump shot that he held way back behind his head and went up very high with it, and it was almost unstoppable. So we had a really good season. We were 20-4, one of the best records that Ramsey High School had had up until that time. After that season, I went on to play at University of Massachusetts. Dick graduated from Ramsey in 1965, went on to play at St. Lawrence University. And then somewhere in the middle of his college days, he decided he really wanted to do something that he loved, which is to fly helicopters. He left school, he enlisted in the U.S. Army, he became a warrant officer and a co-pilot on a UE helicopter that was used in the Vietnam War, and he was stationed in Vietnam. Sadly, on August 8th, 1968, his helicopter, a UE, was hit by a rocket-propelled grenade, and it crashed, and Dick and the other people on the helicopter were killed. I'll never forget, a few weeks after his death, his father, we called him Mr. Oviatt, obviously, came to our house and said he was very proud of his son, that Dick had died a man doing what he wanted to do, to fly helicopters and serving his country.
My name is Jack May. I graduated from Ramsey High School in 1966. Dick Oviatt was a year ahead of me. He was one of my role models. When I entered Ramsey High, it had a great basketball tradition. We underclassmen were well aware of who the stars were on the varsity. Dick, I'm sure, was inspired by and mentored by his older brother Dave, who was the top player on the 1963 team. The 1964 team, Dick's junior year, was led by captain and all-county player Rick Perkins. It was an extremely strong team with an excellent 20-4 record. Coach Gordon Bedford insisted that all players master the fundamentals of the game, and he especially focused on defense. He was a firm believer in man-to-man defense and would only resort to his own defense under special circumstances. Dick Oviatt absorbed all of those lessons. At 6'5", with a good vertical jump, Dick was an excellent scorer with a shot that was almost impossible to block. He was also a good defender down low and quick enough and tall enough to present major problems for the opposition. Looking back at Dick's high school career, he was an eager athlete who participated in baseball, football, and basketball. In his junior and senior years, he focused all of his attention on basketball. These pictures illustrate his commitment to fitness, and yes, basketball shorts of the mid-1960s really were that short. The news of his death in Vietnam came as a stunning shock. My memories of him are good ones, as we shared a common background growing up in Ramsey and a love of the game of basketball. 50-plus years later, he is still missed. On this occasion, your remembrance of him is a fitting tribute to a person who was a great teammate and a patriotic citizen.
Hi, my name is Chip Reed. I graduated from Ramsey High School in 1965, the same year as Dick Oviatt. In 1962, as freshmen, we played basketball for Ramsey High. Dick was growing quite tall, and it took him quite a while to adjust to his new height. By the time we were seniors, he was playing great, with a lights-out jump shot and rebounding off the boards. After high school, Dick went off to college, became a warrant officer, and later went to flight school to become a helicopter pilot for the United States Army. I enlisted in the Marines. In late August of 1968, while I was stationed in Chu Lai, Vietnam, I received a letter from my mother informing me of Dick's death in a helicopter crash. It was devastating, to say the least. In closing, I'd just like to say that Dick Oviatt should be remembered not only as a good friend to many or a great basketball player at Ramsey High, but as a great American who gave his life for his country. Thank you.
My name is Tom Oviatt. I was Dick's younger brother. He was 5 years older than I was, and I'd like to tell you what it was like to be Dick's younger brother. Dick was an amazing athlete in every sport he tried. And being my big brother, he was my hero. I always thought he could do anything. It's not to say we weren't brothers and we didn't fight and I didn't try to annoy him and he didn't keep me in line, but there were parts of Dick's personality that I got to see in a way I think that no one else did. And if we're to honor Dick, I think what I have to say ought to be heard. My father said that Dick lived as if he didn't know he was gonna, as if he did know he wasn't gonna be here that long. And so he tried outrageous experiences. He wasn't afraid to try anything. He didn't care whether he failed. He cared more about the experience and the adventure of trying it. And I thought that was a great lesson to teach to your little brother. The third thing I'd like to tell you about Dick, and probably the most important one, is before Dick went off to Vietnam, he had volunteered, signed up, joined the Army, and joined as a helicopter pilot. And of his class of 125 or so, there were four spots that would go to those who would fly the attack helicopters with the weapons, and the rest of the people in his class would fly the medevac helicopters, and those are the ones who fly into the combat areas to rescue people who are in battle and bring them out. And Dick, knowing that he'd finished somewhere around fifth, he was one or two places away, but he was gonna fly the medevac helicopters. And knowing that, he came to his little brother, me shortly before he left and explained what the situation was. He said, Tom, I'm going to go over into the war and I'm going to be flying medevacs. And that's a dangerous job to have. And there's a reasonable possibility that I won't come back. And if that happens, I want you to learn something from me and remember it. And that is, if I die, I do not want you to feel sorry for me or feel bad or have any regrets, because I won't. I want you to share my happiness that I finally found something that was worth dying for. If I go and serve my country and I give my life because I'm serving my country and I die trying to rescue fallen soldiers, don't you dare feel bad for me. Celebrate that I found something that was important enough to me to give my life. And that message, and all the messages that my big brother Dick gave to me, have always stuck with me. And I learned so much from him. He's still my hero. My oldest son, I named Richard Arthur Oviatt in honor of him. And so I wanted to share the parts of who he was as a big brother and as a person today, in addition to who he was as an athlete. Thank you very much.